In this problem, we'll take a look at financial statement analysis tools and how they're used to evaluate various questions about the company's financial standing. We have a comparative balance sheet with 20X1 being the earliest year and 20X2 being the most recent year. We also have the income statement for the most recent year. We're told that dividends paid during 20X2 totaled $127,000. The market price of a share of common stock was $100 per share. We're given a table of ratios for 20X2 and 20X1, so I've calculated the ratios for you, and you'll use those to answer the next six questions. You can also practice calculating the ratios if you would like. So here is a list of ratios. It's just a partial set of the ratios that we've actually covered in the chapter, but you'll use these to answer the following questions. The first question, has it become easier or more difficult for the company to pay its suppliers and regular bills? We will focus on liquidity, and of the ratios given in the list, the current ratio and the quick ratio are the best indicators of liquidity. And we can see from the list given that both of these increased. And what that means is it has become easier to pay its short-term liabilities in 20X2, the most recent year. Are customers paying their bills at least as fast in year 20X2 as in year 20X1? Since we're looking at how customers are paying their bills, we'll turn our focus to accounts receivable. And we are given our accounts receivable turnover in days. In the earlier year, it took just over 23 days to collect receivables, and in the most recent year, it took 20.53 days. This indicates that we were able to collect receivables more quickly in 20X2. Note that this is in days. It could have been expressed in terms of times per year, and that would change things a bit, but here it's given in days. Did the company sell inventory more quickly in 20X2 or 20X1? We will take a look at the inventory turnover. We can see that it's given in times per year, and this tells us that the company last year, the earlier year, sold their inventory 17.54 times, while in the most recent year, they only sold it 16.8 times. Therefore, they were able to move inventory faster in 20X1. Again, noting this could have been given in days, but it was given in times per year. Discuss the relative profitability over the two-year period. We'll look at our profitability ratios. There are several you could choose from among this list. The most common measures used for profitability are gross margin percentage, return on assets, return on stockholders' equity, and net margin percentage. So when we look at these profitability ratios, you'll notice that the gross margin percentage decreased. That means the company did not control inventory costs as well in the most recent year as compared to the earlier year given. Net margin also decreased, and this indicates the company did not control all expenses as well in 20X2. So cost control seemed to be a bit of a problem in the most recent year. However, rate of return on assets increased. This means management did a better job of using assets to generate a profit. and return on equity also increased. So management was able to use the common shareholders' investment, that is their common stock and additional paid-in capital and the retained earnings that have remained in the company, they were able to use those more effectively in 20X2. So overall profitability was good, but could have been better had they controlled expenses. Now, as a side note, you will be responsible for understanding each individual ratio and what it means if it increased or decreased. You will not be required to give me an essay and give the relative merits of what each of these means. That would be for a higher level course. In which year was the company able to use assets more effectively to generate sales? Now you have to read carefully. Notice that it says use assets to generate sales. We will focus on the asset turnover, which is sales over average total assets. Had this asked how they used assets to generate profit, a better answer would have been the return on assets. But here it was sales. And as you can see, that decreased. So they used the assets more wisely in 20X1 than 20X2. And finally, a loan officer is considering an application submitted by the consolidated distributors to borrow a significant amount of money over a 10-year period. Has it become more or less risky to approve the loan during 20X2? Well, we'll focus on our debt management ratios, and of this list, that would include times interest earned and debt to equity. Times interest earned increased. This means the company was better able to make those periodic interest payments in the most recent year. The debt to equity ratio decreased, and this means it was less risky to loan the company money in 20X2 than it was in 20X1. Remember, higher debt is going to be higher risk. Note that the debt to equity ratio really is your best indicator of risk. And so it looks like it's become less risky to loan the company money in 20X2. From here, if you would like to, you can calculate the ratios for 20X2 just to get some extra practice. But note that the original example in the notes plus the homework will also review all of the ratios, not just the sampling we have here. But tune back in if you decide to get that practice with those ratios.